Hello friends, today we are covering Flamingo book of class 12th, the prose part, and we are starting with the last lesson today. But before we start the last lesson, let us take a look at the deleted part, which is Poets and Pancakes, the interview and going places. So let's begin. The first chapter itself is titled as the last lesson, which is really ironical, but it is a very interesting lesson and it gives us a lot of values. The author is Alphonse Daudet, who was a French novelist and a short story writer. And this lesson has a background of the Franco-Prussian War, which was of 1870 to 1871, in which France was defeated by Prussia. So we are primarily talking about the two small French districts of France, which are Alsace and Lorraine, which have passed into the Prussian lands. So before we get into the lesson, let us look at the map which is provided to us. This is the map. So this is the map of France, and here are the two small French districts of Alsace and Lorraine, the neighboring country Germany. Prussians were a part of Germany and they have annexed the territory of Alsace and Lorraine, and they have regained their power to such extent that in this chapter we will see that they will even impose their language on them. So this concept is called linguistic chauvinism. It means the strong and unreasonable belief that your own country and language is best and important. The story also reflects this. The acquisition of power over the Alsatians made the Prussians so dominating that they even impose their language on them. अगर हम इंडिया से इस कंटेक्स्ट को रिलेट करें तो जब इंडिया में ब्रिटिशर्स आए थे, दे ऑल्सो सॉ आवर कंट्री एज अनएजुकेटेड, नॉट एट ऑल वेस्टर्नाइज, तो उन्होंने भी हमारी लैंग्वेज इम्पोज करने की कोशिश करी, चेंज करने की कोशिश करी, इंग्लिश इंट्रोड्यूस हुई. द सेम थिंग वॉज हैपनिंग इन दिस रीजन, एंड दिस इज़ अ मेन कंसेप्ट ऑन विच द चैप्टर इज बेस्ड. So let's start. Okay, so yahan pe story mein we get an insight into the story through the eyes of France, who is a little boy, and the story starts jab wo late ho raha hai school ke liye, and there is in a great dread. Wo bahut great dread mein hota hai, which means he has a lot of fear of scolding. Why? Because us din uska participles फ्रेंच पार्टिसिपल्स का टेस्ट होता है, बट ही इज़ नॉट प्रिपेयर्ड, सो ही इज़ वेरी इन अ ड्रेडफुल सिचुएशन, इन अ फियरफुल सिचुएशन कि उसे स्कोल्डिंग मिलेगी अपने टीचर से. ठीक है, पहले तो उसने सोचा कि लेट्स स्किप स्कूल एंड लेट अस गो टू रनिंग अवे एंड लेट अस स्पेंड आर डे आउटवर्ड्स. सो उसे बहुत ज़्यादा डिस्ट्रैक्शंस फील होती हैं. द वेदर वॉज वेरी ब्राइट एंड वॉर्म, दैट इज़ द फर्स्ट डिस्ट्रैक्शन. द बर्ड्स वर चर्पिंग एट द एज ऑफ द वुड्स, सेकेंड. And in the open field back of the sawmill, the Prussian soldiers were drilling, the third. So these were all the distractions in the starting when he was going to school, and how his mind was getting distracted to skip the school. So the next line says, it was all much more tempting than the rule of participles, but I had the strength to resist and hurried off to the school. He says that although I had the strength to resist all these distractions, I wanted to go to school, so I hurried it off. Now at that time there was a bulletin board in the town hall, in front of the town hall, and a huge crowd was there in front of the bulletin board. For the last 2 years, all our bad news had come from there. Why bad news has been coming from there? Because Prussian soldiers jo the, jo Prussian ke log the, wo yahan par aakar प्रॉपर्टी और लैंड तो ऑलरेडी वो कन्फिस्केट कर चुके थे, तो उसी के रिलेटेड बैड न्यूज़ आती थी. कैसी न्यूज़ आती थी? इट इज़ गिवन हियर द लॉस्ट बैटल्स, द ड्राफ्ट ऑर्डर्स ऑफ द कमांडिंग ऑफिसर, एंड ऑल सच काइंड ऑफ न्यूज़ वुड कम फ्रॉम दिस बुलेटिन बोर्ड. एंड ही वॉज थिंकिंग कि अब कैसी न्यूज़ आई होगी, बट ही वॉज ना, वो रुका नहीं वहाँ पर, ही वेंट अलॉन्ग टू द स्कूल. अच्छा, वो जल्दी जल्दी जा रहा था. देयर वॉज अ ब्लैकस्मिथ आउट देयर एंड ही मॉक्ड फ्रांस. ही सेड, डोंट गो सो फास्ट बब, यू विल गेट टू योर स्कूल इन प्लेंटी ऑफ टाइम. सो दिस इज़ अ मॉकिंग विच वॉज मेड बाय ब्लैकस्मिथ द वॉचर. अब उसने क्यों ऐसे उसको मॉक किया, विच वी विल गेट टू नो इन फ्यू टाइम. ओके सो लेट्स बिगिन. उसको लगा ही गॉट टू नो दैट ही वॉज मेकिंग फन ऑफ मी. और वो फिर मिस्टर हैमल जो उसके टीचर होते हैं वहाँ के उनके गार्डन के पास पहुँच जाता है. सो वो डिस्क्राइब करता है कि यूजुअली द स्कूल इज़ ऑलवेज इन अ ग्रेट बसल. बसल मीन्स अ लॉट ऑफ चिट चैट, अ लॉट ऑफ नॉइज इज़ देयर इन द स्कूल वेन एवर ही एंटर्ड द स्कूल अर्लियर. बट दिस टाइम इट वॉज अ चेंज विच ही एक्सपीरियंस. अर्लियर देर वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ साउंड ऑफ क्लोजिंग ऑफ डेस्क. लेसन्स वर रिपीटेड इन यूनिसन. इन यूनिसन मीन्स एवरीबडी यूज टू स्पीक इन वन गो वेरी लाउड दैट. ओके वेरी लाउड दे यूज टू स्पीक. सो अ लॉट ऑफ बसल वॉज देयर एंड बट दिस टाइम इट वॉज वेरी साइलेंट. द स्कूल एनवायरमेंट इट वॉज एज क्वाइट एज अ संडे मॉर्निंग. एंड ही ऑल्सो सेज दैट आई हैड काउंटेड ऑन द कमोशन टू गेट माई डेस्क विदाउट बींग सीन. दैट ही हैड डिसाइडेड दैट आई विल एंटर द क्लास without being seen because it was already late and it was very quiet as a Sunday morning. It was a totally different environment in the school. So his classmates, he saw his classmates, they were already in their places. And Mr. Hamel with his iron ruler under his arm, he was walking up and down. So this shows one of the characteristics of Mr. Hamel, which means that he was a really strict teacher. That is why he had an iron ruler. So he opened the door to enter and he was very frightened because he was late. But to his surprise, Mr. Hamel, he said to him, go to your place quickly, little Franz, we were beginning without you. So he was very polite in his manner. Earlier he used to scold him, but now today he was very polite. So it was a shock for Franz. So he went to his bench, he sat and he started noticing the changes in the school that day. The first change which he has already noticed was the silence, which was very unusual to him. Now the second change which he notices was the attire which his teacher Mr. Hamel was wearing. He was wearing a beautiful green coat, his frilled shirt and little black silk cap, all embroidered, that he never wore except on inspection and prize day. So he was wearing a very formal attire that day, which he usually wore on days of inspection or prize day. So he was thinking, what could be the special occasion today that he is wearing such a formal attire? And although the school was also very strange and serious, solemn means serious, so it was very strange and serious, the environment was very different. And one more thing which he noticed was the back benches. The back benches of Franz's classroom usually stayed empty, but today, to his surprise, they were filled. The people from the village had come to sit and attend the French class. He noticed the people. It was a old horse with his three-cornered hat. It was the former mayor, the former postmaster, and several other people. Everybody looked sad. Now, this was another observation which he saw. Ki sab log udas lag rahe the. Hosser had brought an old primer. Primer is kind of a blackboard, you can say a small blackboard, a paper blackboard, you can say chalkboard paper, and which was thumbed at the edges means it was really worn out condition. It was very old, as if it had not been used for ages. So he came to the class with that and he held it open on his knees with his great spectacle lying across the pages. He was very serious and learning. So when he was wondering all this, Mr. Hamel, he started saying something. Now, what did he say? My children, this is the last lesson I shall give you. The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the schools of Alsace and Lorraine. The new master comes tomorrow. This is your last French class lesson. I want you to be very attentive. So this came as a thunder clap. These words were a thunderclap to Franz. Nobody thought that one fine day the environment of the school would be so changed. There would be a lot of change in the environment of the school, and this kind of news would come to them. So why did he call this news, this order from Berlin, a thunderclap? This is really important to understand. the news about the order from Berlin regarding teaching of only German language in Alsac and Lorraine were like a thunderclap to him because they were totally unexpected and made him speechless. Okay, with reference to this context here, thunderclap means a surprise, astonishment. He was really surprised with the kind of the words which Mr. Hamel spoke. So now he got to know. Now he thought that, okay, so that is why there was a lot of crowd in front of the bulletin board. And he got to know why the blacksmith, the watcher, was mocking him. He was saying that, go, don't hurry, you have plenty of time to go to school. It was an ironical statement because it was the last lesson and he was already late because he had never paid attention. So he was mocking at him, right? Now he started regretting, oh my God, it is my last French lesson, I cannot learn it anymore, it is the last day, I have not paid attention earlier, and now also I have a last chance to learn. He says that my books that had seemed such a nuisance a while ago, so heavy to carry, my grammar and my history of the saints were old friends now that I couldn't give up. Why does he say so? Now he started remembering that my books, जो मेरी books थी वो मुझे अभी इतनी ज़्यादा nuisance लग रही थी, so heavy लग रही थी, और अब मैं उनसे कभी catch up ही नहीं कर पाऊँगा दोबारा. I'll not be able to learn them, I'll not be able to read them. Now he feels like this, so he is in a regretful situation, and now he start thinking about Mr. Hamel also, that why he was so sad, and he was himself feeling really sad that he will never see him. Now he forgot that about his ruler, iron ruler, how hard it felt when he used to hit them with it, okay, and how cranky, how serious, how strict he was. So now forget all that thing, only thing that it was the last lesson and the opportunity to learn the French language was out of their hands now. In the honor of his last lesson, he had put on his fine Sunday clothes. Now another thing revealed, that why was he in the very formal attire, because it was in the honor of the language which he has been teaching. Okay, so, and that is all the same reason, because of the same reason the old men also came. And they were sorry. Why were they sorry? Because they never came to school, they never learned the language, and now on the last day they had come to pay their respects to the language and our master. The Mr. Hamel, again a very important thing, Mr. Hamel had dedicated 40 years of faithful service and of showing respect, showing their respect for the country. Okay, so he has been a very faithful teacher who has been teaching French language for over 40 years, and now people have come to pay their respect. Okay, so moving ahead, now while he was wondering, noticing, and he was putting all the parts together, his name was called and he was asked to recite the participle. Okay, so he got up, he mixed at a few words, his heart was beating, but he was not looking up, he was scared because he has never learned them. Now, the teacher got to know that he had never learned them, so Mr. Hamel said, I won't scold you, little Franz, you must feel bad now. See how it is. Every day we have said to ourselves, bah, we have plenty of time, I'll learn it tomorrow, and now you see where we have come out. That's a great trouble with Elsat. She puts off learning till tomorrow. Now those fellows out there will have the right to say to you, how is it you pretend to be Frenchmen and yet you can neither speak nor write your own language? Now the teacher says ki main tumhe daatunga nahi, kyunki this is the attitude which we people carry, that we will study tomorrow, we have plenty of time. But since they were in Alsac region, a very bad thing happened, that they do not have time to learn the language. And now the Prussians, they have a very good reason again to mock at the people of these districts by saying ki tum Frenchmen ho, lekin tumhe apni na to language bolni aati hai aur na hi likhni aati hai. Another thing which will let them down. Okay, so next he says, though Mr. Hamel yahan pe kehte hain ki you are not the only one, okay, little Franz, hum sab ke paas hai jo hame change karna hai, we all have a great deal to reproach ourselves with, we have a lot of things which we have to change, which we have done bad in the earlier times. It was me jo tumhe kabhi kabhi chutti de deta tha, kabhi apna kya kehte फ्लावर्स को वाटर करने के लिए भेज देता था, और कैसे क्या कहते हैं, अ लॉट ऑफ रीजंस की वजह से दे यूज़ टू मिस द क्लासेस. तो ये यहाँ पे बताया गया है, द रिग्रेट बताया गया है कि कैसे वो सैड सिचुएशन में है एंड हाउ दे फील द पेन दैट देयर लैंग्वेज इज़ बीइंग टेकन अवे बाय द प्रूशियंस. ओके, नाउ मिस्टर हैमिल सेज हियर दैट इट वॉज द मोस्ट फ्रेंच लैंग्वेज, इट वॉज द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल लैंग्वेज एंड द मोस्ट क्लियरेस्ट, मोस्ट लॉजिकल. वी मस्ट गार्ड इट अमंग अस एंड नेवर फॉरगेट इट, बिकॉज व्हेन पीपल आर इंस्लेव्ड एज लॉन्ग एज दे होल्ड फास्ट टू देयर लैंग्वेज, इट इज एज इफ दे हैड द की टू देयर प्रिजन. अगेन दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेटमेंट वेयर ही स्टेट्स दैट हाउ मच love he has for the French language, her important, clearest, logical, beautiful language it is in the world. And one important statement he says that jab tak, here he says that jab tak hum apni language ko hold on kar sakte, because language is something which is related to our origin. Like if we are from India, then our language is Hindi, so it is something which is binding us to India. Similarly, एल्साक के लोगों के लिए उनकी लैंग्वेज थी फ्रेंच, और वो यही कहना चाहते हैं यहाँ पे कि जब तक हम अपनी लैंग्वेज के साथ हैं तब तक हमारी क्या कहते हैं, हमें कोई भी अलग नहीं कर सकता. नोबडी कैन पुट अस इन प्रिजन, इट इज़ द की टू आर प्रिजन. इफ एनी प्रॉब्लम अकर्स ऑन द यूनिटी ऑफ द कंट्री, द लैंग्वेज विल बाइंड अस टुगेदर. सो दिस इज व्हाट ही इज ट्राइंग टू से इन इट. नाउ ही स्टार्टेड द लेसन्स एंड फ्रांस एक्सप्लेन्स योर his experience. He states that, oh my god, it was such a great experience. I learned everything. Everything was clear in one go. I had never listened so carefully with so much patience, and everything that Mr. Hamill taught them on that day, it got into their heads at one stroke. So this is what he says. Now he also says one thing that Mr. Hamill ने बहुत सारे एफ़र्ट्स किए थे उस दिन. वो नई कॉपीज़ लेके आए थे उनके लिए, जो जिसके ऊपर फ्रांस अलसैक लिखा हुआ था. वो फ्लैग्स की तरह फ्लोट हो रही थी क्लास के अंदर, और एक रॉड पे उनकी डेस्क के ऊपर भी लगी हुई थी. और उस टाइम पे क्लास में देयर वाज नो अदर बसल एंड ओनली वन साउंड वॉज कमिंग, विच वॉज द स्क्रैचिंग ऑफ द पेन्स ओवर द पेपर. So this shows how dedicated they were that day and how regretful, dedicated on that day, but yet they were regretful for all the days which have passed away and they have not paid attention at that time. Okay, so he says he thinks about the pigeons here. Okay, let me speak out this sentence. Once some beetles flew in, but nobody paid any attention, not even the littlest ones who worked right on tracing their fish hooks as if that was French too. On the roof, the pigeons cooed very low. Will they make them sing in German, even the pigeons? Now this is a very thoughtful situation as to why France says so. He says this because the statement here, it refers to the extreme desperation of the Frenchmen towards the German authorities. How desperated they felt, that how irritated and how, you know, sad they felt towards the authorities. It was very painful for them to adopt a new language, although they never paid attention to the French language. But the thought, the order that French will be no more available to them, it was really disheartening for all of them. So it was very painful for them. And now taking away their own language from them, it would be very unfair, very unkind. And he thinks here that language is something which is very natural. It is as natural as it comes to the pigeons. Pigeons belonging to French and they are suited to their French environment. And similarly, the people belonging to France, the language also comes in a natural way to them because it is their origin, it is a part of their origin. And now he also adds, he means by this statement that even if they paid huge attention, huge devotion to their mother tongue, situation would have been better. But now all of this, their right to learn their mother tongue, to speak in their mother tongue, they have been engulfed by the German atrocities, and the authorities have taken away all such kinds of rights, right? So this is very important statement which we have done it, and now let us move ahead. Now he talks about that how the garden was, what was the environment of Mr. Hamel's classroom, and how they used to study. And now he thinks about the teacher, that oh my god, how disheartening would be for him, because his sister, who was in the another floor on the top of the classroom, she was packing trunks. That means he was leaving. Okay, he was leaving the next day, because he was a true Frenchman. He had been teaching French for 40 years, and now suddenly the order came to teach German, and so he was leaving the country the next day. But they continued with the, you know, the lessons in history and all that. Everybody was very serious. Everybody was in a crying mood. They were very, you know, they were filled with emotions. And he says that, oh my god, my last lesson would be memorable. I would really remember my last lesson. It was very nice and emotional as well. Now, all at once, the church clock struck 12. Then the angelus, at the same moment, the trumpets of Prussians returning from drill sounded under our windows. Mr. Hamel stood up, very pale in his chair. I never saw him look so tall. My friends, he said. But something choked him. He could not go on. Yahan pe trumpets of the Prussians returning from the drill sounded under our windows. यहाँ पे स्टेटमेंट का मीनिंग सिर्फ इतना नहीं है कि विंडो की साइड से प्रूशियन सोल्जर्स आ रहे थे. इट हैज़ अ डीप मीनिंग विच सेज कि विंडो की साइड से सिर्फ प्रूशियन के सोल्जर्स चल कर नहीं आ रहे थे. इट वॉज द डॉन ऑफ प्रूशिया विच वॉज एंट्रिंग इन टू द डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ एल्साक एंड लोरेन. वो सिर्फ मेयरली सोल्जर्स की तरह नहीं घूम रहे थे. इट वॉज अ फेस विच वॉज चेंजिंग, अ चेंजिंग फेज, अ चेंजिंग टाइम, चेंजिंग ऑफ पावर हैज़ बीन सीन. जो एल्साक के हाथ से सब कुछ चला गया था, एंड एवरीथिंग वॉज बींग ट्रांसफर टू द प्रूशियंस, इवन देयर ओन लैंग्वेज. सो मिस्टर हेमल वॉन्टेड टू से समथिंग, बट समथिंग चोक्ड हिम. ऐसा होता है इन सिचुएशन वेन वी आर वेरी, यू नो, सैड, एंड वेन आर इमोशंस आर हाइटेंड. इट इज़ अ डिफिकल्टी we face while speaking. So the same thing happened with Mr. Hamel. So he took out his chalk and he wrote on the blackboard as large as he could. He wrote, Vive la France. What is Vive la France? Vive la France means long live France. This shows the love for the language he had, and the message which he wanted to convey, that even though German is being imposed, the Prussian dawn has been seen in the districts of Alsace and Lorraine, still he wanted to convey a message that long live France, you will always be in our hearts and we respect you. Then he says, school is dismissed, you may go. So in this way, hamara ye chapter jo hai wo khatam ho jata hai. Now there are certain things, the values which are associated with this chapter, jo ki hame isko padhne ke baad mein pata chalti hai. Realizing the worth of a thing after losing it. ये बहुत ही ज़्यादा evident है पूरी story में. जो regret उनको feel होता है पूरे time जब वो लोग बैठे होते हैं, whatever they are doing, only one thing is there at the back of their mind, that is the regret which they have of not learning the language, their own mother tongue. Next value is respect for one's language. It means that even though we do not pay attention, somewhere or the other, at the back of mind, at the back of our heart, we always have a respect. And there are certain ways and means which have been shown in the chapter by which the people of Elsac paid their respects to the language. Never shy away from learning. Now, village people set an example here. Although they didn't go to school in their times, but they came today to show that there is no shying away in learning and there is no age bar for learning as well. Okay, so if we move down, here is the theme of the chapter. The pain that is inflicted on the people of a territory by its conquerors by taking away the right to study or speak their own language. The whole chapter, it gives a reflection of their pain, of how painful they felt. Their territory is already gone, but Now their language, their right to speak or study in their own mother tongue is also being taken away by the Prussians. So how painful the process is. This is the theme of the chapter, which is very much visible. And the sub-theme is student and teacher attitudes to learning and teaching. The chapter not only gives us a wider view of how the territories get annexed and how painful the process is, it also gives an insight into Mr. Hamel's and France, you know, relationship of a teacher and a student, of how, you know, cranky France thought Mr. Hamel was, but the moment he got to know that he will not be able to see him anymore, or he'll not be learning from him, so he suddenly felt a change. So this is what is it. We always realize the worth of a thing after losing it. And at last, I would also like to repeat one more topic which I have already discussed with you, which is linguistic chauvinism. It is a very important topic. The whole background, the base of the chapter is this. Again, it is the strong belief which the Prussians had that their own language and their own country is important, and they not only, you know, annexed the territories, they became so powerful, so dominating, that they tried to impose the language on them. And the next day, which we have already seen, the German teacher will come. So it is a very painful thing. This is about the linguistic chauvinism. And here I end the last lesson. I hope you understand. Feel free to comment down below for any queries, and I'll reach out to you soon. And if you're new to my channel, then don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that whenever I get a new video, you get to know it. Thanks. Bye-bye.